Well, everybody, it's that time. It's time for graduation, the day that we've all been waiting for. A big congratulations to our seniors who persevered with hard work and endurance over the last 4 years. And a special congratulations to all of our students, staff, and parents who got through this unique time of remote learning this year. Anyway, they're about to begin. So have a seat, make yourself comfortable. On with the show.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to a celebration of our class of 2020. Everyone, please rise for our national anthem, performed by senior Jeremy Silber.
Good afternoon. Today we celebrate the class of 2020. Graduation has always been the highlight of the school year. It is one of the most memorable rituals in one's lifetime. I know today's graduation is not what we envisioned. It's not the traditional graduation. A virtual graduation looks different. But it doesn't change how far you've come and how far you're going. For sure, there's been a lot of change these past few months, many challenges and many losses. But no matter what, dear graduates, this is your day. We have had the joy of watching you grow over the last 4 years into wonderful young women and men. The world awaits you, ready to be improved by your individual talents, strengths, and resiliency. I know there are a lot of emotions, love, and warm feelings today as your parents, family members, teachers, friends, and fellow students share in the memories and dreams that are in your hearts. So now let us enjoy Commencement 2020. Thank you. It is a pleasure to now announce our academic achievement. The first award will be in English, and it is my pleasure to give the award to Alexander Small. It is my pleasure to announce that Ian Raybeck is getting the History Award. The Literature Award goes to Jackson Lustberg. Math is awarded to Aaron Brining. Science is awarded to Jedediah Hall.
One of our special subject area awards this year is given in computers to Alexander Small. Our award in drama is given to Rebecca Burrows. Our music award goes to Jeremy Silber. Our arts and graphics award goes to Jedediah Hall. And our photography award goes to Alexander Small. This year's athletic awards, outstanding sportsmanship award goes to Anthony Hungria. And the awards for outstanding athletes go to Thomas Chung and Jade Vacco. The 2020 Award for Citizenship and Community Service goes to Cindy Lou Coleman Polanski and Anthony Hungria. The 2020 Award for School Service goes to Joseph Ferrandino. Thank you.
The end of this school year has been anything but normal. And we all are so very proud of everyone and how hard you've worked under these unusual circumstances. David Gressel has produced this video with that in mind. The school that you knew so well may already seem like a distant memory, but I hope that this video brings those memories back to life. Hopefully, we can all be together soon. But until then, know that we've missed you all terribly and the energy that you've brought to these now empty halls.
This is normal. Take your time, you'll find you've got nothing but time. These days, these long, long days, all we have for now. When the sunshine turns to pain, Try not to let it make you great. This ain't normal. No, it ain't normal. Take your time, don't move so fast. We gotta make it last for each other. We'll get together soon, underneath some other pink moon.
Parents Association has given scholarships to four members of the graduating class of 2020. It's my pleasure to award those scholarships to Rebecca Burrows, Joseph Ferrandino, Monet Fuller, and Jackson Lustberg. The Dennis Cohen Memorial Scholarship is awarded to a graduating senior or seniors who plans to further his or her education and possesses the qualities that best exemplify our former director's mission. They must be motivated to succeed, show leadership qualities, be motivated and involved in activities at community high school, demonstrate civic involvement or community service, and must have integrity. Seniors had to apply for this scholarship and write an essay describing what they are passionate about. The funds for this scholarship are generated annually by donations received in order to keep Dennis's mission and his memory alive. It is my pleasure to present the Dennis Cohen Memorial Scholarship to three seniors this year: Brianna Durbin, Cassandra Ferry, and Anthony Hunger.
It has always been a pleasure for me to bestow the most important award, and that is the award for the Outstanding Scholar of the Year. This year is no exception. The Outstanding Scholar Award is given to the student who, in the opinion of the faculty, has put forth consistent effort and achieved academic excellence. This year's Outstanding Scholar totally fulfills these criteria. Jackson Lustberg is an outstanding and intelligent young man. As a student, his strengths are demonstrated by his hard work and work ethic. He goes beyond the surface of what is being taught and looks for a clear understanding and deeper meaning. Jackson is willing to ask questions that show he is committed to his learning. His unique perspective allows him to look at the many sides of topics and come away with a more welded, rounded picture. Teachers describe him as one of the kindest people around. In fact, he was voted one of the friendliest people in this year's yearbook. He is a shoulder to lean on, no matter who the needy student is. He treats every student with kindness, fairness, and understanding. Additionally, he's tolerant, he's patient, he's easygoing, he's humorous, and he's witty. One of his senior teachers summed it up perfectly. Jackson is an A student, and his character is one that is unmatched and most certainly make his parents very proud. Jackson's an all-around awesome kid. Jackson also has many interests. Here at the high school, he played varsity soccer, was a member of United for Service and the History Club. Also, he was on the technical side of all of Community High School's production, and he is a most valued peer mentor. Outside of school, Jackson works as an animal therapy handler, and alongside his father, sets up lighting for special events. I believe his future looks quite bright as he moves on to Marist College to major in fitness training. He has already taken pre-college courses at Marist. I know Community High School will miss him greatly, and we wish him the best of luck. He will truly be an asset wherever he goes in life. It gives me great pleasure to present the 2020 Community High School Award for Outstanding Scholar to Jackson Lusberg. Congratulations.
Each student has brought something special to our school and has experienced CHS in their own unique way. This year, we've asked seniors to say something positive as they remember their time at CHS. They've all worked very hard to get here, and many of them would like to take this opportunity to thank their parents, their family, and their teachers. Hearing them talk about these things they'll miss, their favorite classes, their teachers, as well as what they have for their future plans, gives us just a glimpse into what CHS has meant to them and what they have all meant to us.
I would like to thank my parents, my teachers, staff, principals, everyone in that school. The most teacher I would miss would be Aaron, Trish, Nick, all the teachers and staff, everyone. Something unique about me is that I really like helping people a lot, and I'm a good person, and I would like to be a good friend.
Hey CHS, Aaron here. I just wanted to take a moment to say how much I'm gonna miss this school. I have learned a lot. I've made lots of friends. I just wanted to say thank you for all you've done to make me prepare for college. I am going to miss that about CHS. I wish all my friends the best of luck in college.
I would like to congrats all of you guys. You guys did a good job with all 4 years. You guys put up with the work. You guys put up with the teachers, even though they were annoying. It's okay. One thing I'm going to miss about the school is being around the teachers, being around my friends, and, hanging out with Rhonda at lunch. Congratulations to you all. I will miss all of you guys, plus the teachers. So, yeah. Good job.
This class of 2020 is extra special because we have been together for 7 years. It all began at the lower school. And when we had our eighth grade graduation, we cried then, and we're probably gonna cry now too. Thank you so much to every single teacher that has been in my life for the past 4 years. I love you from the bottom of my heart. And yeah, happy graduation, guys.
just want to say that this year has been crazy. You know, I hope everyone stayed safe. And I just want to give out a shout out to the next year's seniors. You know, good luck. Good luck on everything. You know, have a blast. You only live once. Shout out to all my teachers, Hines, Ms. Poway, Mr. DeProspo, Natalia, all the study skills. And just everyone to CHS. You know, I hope everybody has a good year. You know, stay safe. I will miss you guys. I'm also going to miss all my friends. Have a great year. Peace.
So I just wanted to thank all of my teachers. You guys are honestly my supporters. You guys are my editors. I also wanted to thank my parents. I can't forget about them. Ira and Val, shout out to you. I love you guys so much, and you've honestly been my number one fan all of my life. You two are the backbone. I would also like to thank the community that community school has provided for me. You guys are honestly one big family, and without the love and support that family has given me, I definitely would not be the person I am today. So thank you so much.
Hey CHS, it's Michael DeSergo. I'd like to shout out my class of 2020, and now I'd like to acknowledge a couple of teachers I had over the years. Miss Wendy, Miss Molino, Miss Delphine, and daughter Miss Levy. Thank you so much, and I wish everybody good luck in the future. Bye.
I just wanna thank a bunch of people in my life, starting off with my parents. I love you guys. Thank you for getting the help that I needed in fighting for me. Thank you to my family for always being there for me no matter what and supporting my decisions. I want to thank my teachers for helping me along this journey. I want to thank my friends for the best 10 years of my life. I am so proud of the accomplishments that we have made together and the memories that we have made together. I will treasure them forever. I love you all so much. Thank you so much. Congratulations to everyone. I can't wait to see what the future holds.
I will never forget these 4 years. They've all been like a trial. We have to get over a wall and get past that wall. It's been a trial for all of us. And no matter what we have gone through, we still made it this far. So one thing I'd like to leave to all the to next year's seniors, never give up no matter what. Time to fly.
I can't name each and every teacher that has affected my life over the last 4 years. But I would like to take this opportunity to say thank you to each and every one of you. Thank you for all the positive messages of encouragement. Thank you to myself for becoming a star, for letting the seed grow into the sunflower we all love. I did it. Thank you to my family, I love you guys. Thank you to my friends for standing by me when I needed your support. Thank you to my CHS family. I will miss you. Bye.
I would like to thank the entire CHS staff for making me into the person I am today. I would like to thank Martin for teaching me practical skills, and Margie, and Kristen Keenan for teaching me how to write my thoughts and convey them clearly. I would like to thank Daniel Silvestro, who's an excellent history teacher, and Dan McChesney.
Hey guys, I just want to say to all my teachers, thank you guys for everything for the past year. Miss you, thanks for everything. For my friends, I love you guys so much, and I hope you guys have a great journey.
4 years, wow. I did not expect to be doing this so soon. I really want to thank my teachers and the administration who near universally made the effort to connect with me on a personal level. I know I was more than a little difficult at times, but it really made all the difference. I also want to specifically thank Dave and Lisa. Without your support and confidence in me, there isn't a chance I'd be on the path I'm on today, so thank you.
Thank you to every teacher. Whether I spent a year or 2 years or 3 years or 4 years in your class, thank you. Mr. Fleischel, Miss Levy, Miss Molino, who taught me a lot about growth. Sharon, who has seen me at my worst so many times. Mr. McChesney, who has been the first person I talked to at community. Silvestro, stay out of trouble. I'll miss you, man. Sisti, who I have had all 4 years with, you have made me a better human being. Thank you for everything you've taught me. Thank you.
What's up, community class of 2020? Congratulations to you all. We did it. I want to thank the community, staff, and teachers for all the support and guidance. To all my friends, thank you for the great memories and the fun times. I'll miss you all. To my basketball teammates and coaches, thank you for all the great memories. Mom, thank you for all the unconditional love and support. Thank you for being my advocate, my number one fan. I'm excited to be a part of Brockford Class of 2024. And to all my fellow classmates, remember, the next chapter of our lives is about to be lit.
I would like to thank my family for supporting and helping me throughout high school. The thing I'm gonna miss the most about high school is friends. And my message to the future seniors of CHS is never give up.
CHS, I just want to say thank you so much for all the CHS teachers and all that you've done over the last 4 years. And thank you so much to my family and friends. I couldn't have done it without you, and I love you guys.
Hi, I'd like to take the opportunity to thank my teachers, my friends, and especially my parents. I'm going to miss the teachers for the lessons they taught me, my friends that I'm going to miss like crazy, but cherish the memories we've made. My parents, thank you for all that you have done for me and above beyond. CHS family, thank you for everything. I really appreciate it. It's been real. Love ya all. Bye.
Hello, class of 2020. We're finally here. We made it. I would like to thank my teachers, my classmates, everything, even Rhonda. Rhonda, I'm gonna miss you. I hope you guys have a great future. Well, something unique about me is that I like to talk, and I talk a lot. Who talks more than me? Nobody, exactly. If you want to do something, do it. Who's stopping you? Just do it. And
I would like to thank my parents for sending me to community high school and my teacher for helping me with doing homework and stuff. And my favorite memories in class is to spend time with my friends and getting to know them better. My future is to follow my dream and start a new chapter.
I'd like to thank my parents for their help along the way, my teachers for doing such an excellent job providing me with knowledge over the years, and my friends for being there to make sure that every day was that much more enjoyable. It's tough to pick a favorite memory, but there's a few highlights from over the years. These include meeting and bonding with new friends, facing my fears to rock the stage in the talent shows, and even little things like seeing my friends at lunch. Obviously, I can't list everybody that I'll miss, but I can name a few standouts. these include my fellow seniors, Alex Small and Jed Hall, as well as a few notable teachers like John Hines, Cheryl Petway, and Tony Gopo. But that's not to discount any of my other friends or teachers. I'm going to miss all of you, and I promise I'll come back to see you again.
I would like to thank Nick and Martin because they helped me. Nick helped me with my homework. My favorite classes was shop because I got to do a lot of things. My future plans are to go to BMCC Community College in Manhattan. The most I will miss is April because she helped me with reading. All right, thank you.
It's been a great 4 years, CHS. I'd like to thank my family, friends, and teachers. Thank you for all the memories. It's been real. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
I would like to thank my mom and my dad for making me the man I am today. I would like to thank my teachers for teaching me and my friends for supporting me. My favorite memory of CHS has to be acting in the play sophomore year, You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. And my advice for any future senior, make the most of your senior year because it's going to go by fast.
Hey guys, you know, it's crazy. Graduating 2020. I know a lot of things are crazy right now. You know, I want to say I'm going to miss all of you guys. You know, all my, you know, graduates, all my teachers. And honestly, you know, how thankful I was, you guys. You know, to have you guys this past 4 years. And shout out to everybody that's been going to the community since, you know, sixth grade. You guys have been friends for, what, 8-9 years? You know, it's just be crazy, you know, leaving each other, you know, to all keep in contact. You know, we're really grateful, parents and all that. You know, I think that's it. You know, just shout out to the family. You know, it's crazy time, you know. We got this. We got this, guys.
I'd like to thank my mother for, well, being her. Mr. Hines, Mr. Peduccio, and Ms. Keenan for writing my recommendations. Ms. Petway for helping me with my college essay and the two other essays I needed for getting into two other universities. My favorite memory, it would most likely have to be involving the photo club, but also a lot of great memories with the guys at the gazebo, so that's just also great. I'll be going to Rider University. Woo, Bronx forever! To study game design, so that's nice. Nice stuff.
We now call upon our Director of Education, Toby Braunstein, to spotlight each of the wonderful graduates of the class of 2020.
Garth Abduli. Garth will be going to community college. He's going as a liberal arts major, and he's interested in business and computers. Garth played basketball and volunteers at a food bank. Gabriel Bissell. Gabe is going to SUNY Albany for business. He was a member of United for Service, the Student Council, the Drama Club, and Productions, and he did community service at the lower school. He also created his own business called Lexico Reseller Company. Additionally, he was a camp counselor. Aaron Brining. He will be going to Manhattanville College for computer science. Aaron received a Manhattanville scholarship of $15,400 annually. He belonged to the Spanish, drama, computer, and game clubs. He takes Taekwondo and has achieved the high red belt. He's also been a camp counselor. Heaven Bullock. She is going to the University of Hartford to major in liberal arts. She's interested in nursing and elementary education. She received the University of Hartford scholarship of $19,000 annually. She belonged to United for Service, played volleyball, softball, and did cheerleading. She also did community service at our lowest school. She worked at a New York youth summer camp and volunteered at Mount Sinai Hospital. Rebecca Burrows will be going upstate to SUNY Delhi for hotel and restaurant management. She belonged to United for Service, was on the student council, did cheerleading and drama. She also belonged to the Spanish and radio clubs. She did community service at our lower school, and she volunteers at a day camp. Ethan Carson. Ethan is going to Rowan University as a biochemistry major. He belonged to United for Service, was on the bowling, computer, billiards, and radio clubs. Thomas Chung. He's going to Bergen Community College for criminal justice. He was on the student council, played basketball, soccer, and was in drama productions. He as well as doing community service at our lowest school. Cindy Lou Coleman Polanski, she's going to Curry College for creative writing. She received the Curry College scholarship of $29,000 annually. She also received the Martin Luther King Award. She belonged to United for Service, student council, was a peer leader, played softball, volleyball, was in drama productions on the dance team, and it was a counselor at Camp Kinderland. Nayeli Cordero, she is going to CUNY College of Staten Island as a liberal arts major. She is interested in math and hopes to become an airplane pilot. She was on student council, played basketball, did cheerleading, and works in childcare. Michael DeServo, he's starting at Bergen Community College, and then he will plan to go to Lincoln Tech Institute for auto mechanics. He did school service, played basketball, baseball, football, and he also works at an auto parts store. Brianna Durbin, she's going to Florida to Lynn University for liberal arts, and she's interested in fashion and early childhood education. She received the Lynn University scholarship of $15,000 annually. She belonged to United for Service, was a peer leader. She was on the dance team, did cheerleading, community service at our lowest school, and outside of school, she is very involved with dance. Joshua Falcone, he is going to CUNY College of Staten Island for computer science. He was in the history, math, radio, billiards, and game clubs. He was also a camp counselor and volunteers at church. Joseph Ferrandino, he's going to Massachusetts to American International College as a liberal arts major, and he's interested in sports management. He received the American International College scholarship of $25,000 a year annually. He will be playing NCAA Division II football. Here at the high school, he was a peer leader, did school service, community service at our lower school, played varsity football and lacrosse for Staten Island. Cassandra Ferry, she's going to Bergen Community College for health science. She belonged to United for Service, played basketball, volleyball, softball, was a cheerleader, and was on the dance team. She did community service at our lowest school, and she does taekwondo as well as karate. Samuel Fisher, he's going to SUNY Cobleskill for canine management. He did United for Service, school service, baseball, soccer, fishing, drama, and he's also traveled quite extensively. Monet Fuller, She's going to Western Connecticut State University for liberal arts and would love to go into the field of dentistry. She belonged to United for Service, was a peer leader, played volleyball, softball, did cheerleading and dance. She also did community service at Lower School. Christian Gonzalez. He is going to CUNY, New York City College of Technology for entertainment technology and video and audio technology. He's on a full scholarship and he's doing the CUNY Excelsior Award. Community High School saw him in many drama and music productions. He did school service as well. Outside of school, he was a stage manager, an auto technician, and assistant director in New York. Justin Green is going to Stockton University for liberal arts. He's interested in business and criminal justice, as well as sports management. He was on the student council, did school service, played basketball. He also plays for the New Jersey Bulls Travel Basketball League. Jed Hall, he is going to Pratt University for art and animation. He received the Pratt University scholarship of $30,000 annually. He was on the United for Service program. He was a peer leader, belonged to the history, bowling, and photography clubs. He also did community service at the Lower School, and he did take pre-college courses at FIT. Anthony Hungria, he is going to SUNY Brockport University as a physical education major. He was a peer leader, played basketball, did our yearbook, did community service at our lowest school, and he belongs to a travel basketball league. Ashley Jean-Pierre, she is going into the workforce. Here at the high school, she was in the drama, music, and art clubs. She also worked as a lifeguard and enjoys art classes and volunteers at church. Massimo Leandre, he is going to CUNY Queensborough Community College as a criminal justice major. He belonged to the billiards club. Outside of school, he was a tennis counselor and a landscaper. Jackson Lusberg is going to Marist College for fitness training. He received the Marist College scholarship of $30,000 annually. He belonged to United for Service, was a peer leader, played soccer, was in the drama and history clubs as well. He is an animal therapy handler and works lighting at events with his dad. He did pre-college courses at Marist in game design. Courtney McGill is going to CUNY College of Staten Island for film directing. She was in the math, drama, bowling, and dance club. She did community service at our lowest school and was a camp counselor and volunteered at a shelter. Ariana Morales is going to makeup designery for cosmetology. She belonged to United for Service, was a peer leader, played softball, volleyball, cheerleading, and dance. She did community service at the lower school. Danais Munoz is going to the University of Hartford for liberal arts and psychology. She also received the University of Hartford scholarship of $43,000 annually. She belonged to United for Service, was a peer leader, played softball, volleyball, and did cheerleading. She also worked at a New York youth summer camp. Jaylene Polanco is going to CUNY Borough of Manhattan Community College to major in liberal arts. She's interested in early childhood education and would love to be a pediatrician. She belonged to United for Service, played softball, did drama, cheerleading and dance here at the high school. She also did community service at our lower school. Ian Rabeck is going to William Patterson University as a liberal arts major. He's interested in photography as well as architecture. He received the William Patterson University scholarship of $9,000 annually. He belonged to United for Service, was a peer leader, and was a part of the history and photo clubs. He did community service at our lowest school, and he is an Ocean County photo contest winner. Ryan Reynoso, he is going to Five Towns College for audio recording technology. He belonged to United for Service, was on student council, and belonged to the music and drama clubs. He volunteers at Hackensack Hospital and works at Camp Dream Street, a special needs camp. Jose Rodriguez, he's going to the Cooney Borough of Manhattan Community College for criminal justice. He did school service. Outside of school, he is a New York Fire Department Junior Explorer. He also did community service for many different organizations. Patrick Schulach, he's going to SUNY Delhi for plumbing and electrician. He did school service, played basketball and baseball. He did community service at our lowest school and belongs to the Travel Basketball League. He also was a caddy at a golf club. Jeremy Silva, he's going to St. Thomas Aquinas College to major in history. He received the St. Thomas Aquinas College scholarship of $11,000 annually. He was on student council, was in the history, drama, and music club. He did community service at our lowest school, and he volunteered at Challenger Little League Baseball. Jordan Singh, he is going to Centenary College for biology, and he received the Centenary University Scholarship of $37,000 annually. He was on student council, belonged to United for Service, played basketball, baseball, and drama. He did voluntary work and community service and was a camp counselor. Alexander Small, he's going to Rider University for game and interactive media design. He received the Rider University scholarship of $26,000 annually. He belonged to the photography and fishing clubs. He received the Future Science Award, a figure skating award as well. He did pre-college Fairleigh Dickinson University courses in game design and film.
Congratulations to the graduating class of 2020.
Tell you to run. see me with the young. Well, pick me.
So proud of you all. Congratulations.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. Good luck in college, guys.
Sorry we're not with you, but we wish you all the best.
Well, I would like to hold my little hand. How we will run with, how we will cry with. I would like to hold my little hand. How we will run with, how we will cry.
Congratulations, guys.
Action. Chaucer, I never get a chance to sit down and read my Chaucer, you know, just want to hang out, read these books instead of just sitting in front of them the whole time, just actually sit down and read them. Are you guys still here? What are you doing here? Graduation is over, it's summer vacation, everyone go have fun, bye!